Shared calendars are a powerful tool that allows multiple users to collaborate and stay organized by sharing access to their calendars. In this video, we'll take you through the step-by-step process of adding an event to a shared Google Calendar, ensuring that everyone involved stays on the same page. Let's say you have been invited to a Google Calendar, or you have created one by yourself. You can now start adding events. Open the Google Calendar app. If you tap on the three dots menu, you will see my calendars. I have one with my wife to be sure we always have events planned together. If you see your shared calendar, that means you have access at least to view the calendar. Now tap on the plus icon from the bottom right. Tap on Event. You see here the calendar add pop-up. We need to check if we can add an event to a shared calendar. Tap on this part. You will see a list of calendars where you can post events. If you do not see the shared calendar in this list, then it means the organizer of the calendar did not provide you access to add events, only to view them. You cannot do anything at this point. You just need to talk with the owner of the calendar to give you access to add events. If you can select the shared calendar, like I can do, then you are good to go to the next step. Fill in the event details, such as the event title, date, time, and location. If you want to invite specific people to the event, click the Add Guests button and enter their email addresses. Click Save. Now this event has been added to the calendar. The beauty of shared calendars lies in collaboration. You can share events with others, allowing them to view and edit the details. By following these simple steps, you can easily add an event to a shared Google Calendar, collaborate with others, and stay organized. Shared calendars are a powerful tool for teams, families, and groups of any kind, promoting efficiency, communication, and coordination. So start using shared Google Calendars today and take your productivity to the next level. I hope you found this video helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. And don't forget to like and subscribe for more tech tips and tutorials. Thanks for watching.